Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to verify the following trig identity. Here we have 2 times cosine squared 2 theta minus cosine of 4 theta is equal to 1. First thing I notice here is that I've got a lot going on my left-hand side. That's the more complicated side, so that's where I'm going to do my work. And then I also notice that each one of these angles, here I'm doubling an angle, and then over here I'm actually quadrupling an angle. So I want to do something or make a substitution so that these angles here are easier to work with, and also so it's easier for me to see if I can use some other trig identity. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to let x equal 2 theta. And what that means is now is if I double x, if I multiply x times 2, then that means I'd multiply 2 times this 2 theta. And we see 2 times 2 theta actually comes out to be 4 theta. So here I see that x is equal to 2 theta. And 2x is equal to 4 theta. So I'm going to leverage that and actually rewrite to simplify what this trig equation looks like. So here, matter of fact, let's change the colors so that we can see the difference. So here we have 2 cosine squared. Instead of 2 theta, I'm going to use x. And I'm going to use parentheses here so it's easily seen. Minus cosine. And instead of 4 theta, I'm going to use 2x. And then my right-hand side stays the same. Right, next thing I notice is that I've got a double angle here, so I'm going to use my double angle identity for cosine to help me make a substitution or do something here to actually simplify. So over here I know that the cosine of 2x is actually equal to cosine squared x minus sine squared x. So this here is the identity that I'm going to leverage in this equation. So here we have cosine of 2x. I'm going to replace that with cosine squared x minus sine squared x. So this portion here stays the same as 2 cosine squared x minus, and I need to use parentheses, or here I'm going to use square brackets because I have two terms here. If I don't use the square brackets, this negative would only apply to this first term. I want that negative to apply to both terms. So I've got the bracket here, and I'm writing in cosine squared x minus sine squared x. And again, this is equal to 1. And now I'm going to distribute this negative to each one of these terms. So here I have 2 cosine squared x minus cosine squared x plus sine squared x. And that there's all set equal to 1. Here I have 2 cosine squared x's, and I have 1 cosine squared x, and I'm subtracting. So that resolves down to just leave me with just a cosine squared x. Then I have a plus sine squared x, and that there's set equal to 1. And again, if you remember, this here is the Pythagorean identity. So cosine squared x plus sine squared x is the same thing as 1. So here I have 1 is equal to 1, and that there is enough to prove that this equation is true by using the double angle for cosine identity and using the Pythagorean identity. All right, that sums up this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on our Facebook page. Also subscribe to that YouTube channel. You can see previous videos and also be more aware of newer videos coming out. And as always, thank you for watching.